Oh my goodness, it's that time already. People of Earth, how are you? Good evening and welcome to episode 95 of the House Arrest Concert Series. Plowing into my third year of doing this nonsense. We got a good one for you tonight. I hope. I'm beginning to regret asking for suggestions / requests, but hey, you know, I was stumped earlier in the week, so tonight I've got a whole bunch of stuff, and there's also a bunch of stuff that I'm going to have to defer till next week. Tonight I'm doing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Doing 8 covers. 2 of those were ones that I had already planned, and the other 6 were suggestions from the Galerie des Cacouettes. That's a French peanut gallery. See if this is any good. I'm up on the tight wire, size ice in the one spire. It's a circus game with you and me. Up on the tight rope, one side's hate and one is hope. But the top hat on my head is all you see. And the wire seems to be the only place for me. The debut single of his from 1972 on the Carney LP. It hit number 11 for him in 1972. Let's take a look at the recording device. All right. Florida, we got Indiana, we got New Jersey. Very nice. Thanks everyone for joining. First one was suggested by two people. One generically said more Leon Russell, one specifically said Tightrope. So what the hell? Give it a shot. The second one is also recommended by two people. But let's talk about the day, shall we? Today April 2nd, 2022, 4222. Today is World Autism Awareness Day. It was also National Love Our Children Day, National Peanut Butter and Jelly Day, and you know, you love your kids, give them a PB&J. Having trouble with your kids, it's also National Reconciliation Day. Reconciliation is always a good thing. It is National Handmade Day, not the Elizabeth Moss, Margaret Atwood handmade. Handmade, M-A-D-E, but like crafty stuff. People who work with their hands. And it's also Ferret Day. A relative of the otter, I come to find out. What else today? Your TV time machine. Turn it back to 1956 and catch the debut of two CBS soap operas, The Edge of Night and As the World Turns. And then in 1978, a primetime soap opera, Dallas, debuted on this date. CBS again. Birthdays today, 1948, Emmy Lou Harris. And going back a few more years to 752, Charlemagne was born today. And I can trace my heritage on my mother's side back to Charlemagne. Yeah, I know. Just to brag a little bit. Some people died on this day too in 2005. J2P2, Pope John Paul II. He was 84 years old. Buddy Rich died in 1987 on this day, and he was 69. And in 1998, at the tender age of 33, Rob Pilatus, who was half of Milli Vanilli, passed away, like I said, at 33. In 1969, Bruce Springsteen's group, Child, debuted at the Pandemonium Club in Wanamassa, New Jersey. I didn't explore it any further than that, but I'm sure there are reviews somewhere. What else happened today? 1917 on this date, the United States declared war on Germany, entering into World War I. Also in 1917, Jeanette Rankin, the first woman congressperson, was sworn in. And finally in 1914, Alec Guinness was born. He passed away in 2000. So, next song. Two people asked for it. We'll see if I can do it. From 1968's Child is Father to the Man, the first Blood, Sweat, and Tears album, Al Kooper's finest work. And he wrote this song. We'll see if I can do anything with it.
Beside me, yeah. than every young boy knows about. He fights his whole soul, all the best to find some. I was a young boy till I held her in my arms. Now I find that I'm strung out behind some.
Single, so it didn't chart on Billboard Hot 100. Neither did this one, surprisingly. Great song. Thanks to my brother for the suggestion. Stevie Wonder for you. From Songs in the Key of Life, 1976. Never charted. This next song was one that was in the chamber before I requested requests. And this was a hit a couple of times. It was written actually originally for Little Anthony and the Imperials back in 1965. But they turned it down because there was a royalty dispute between the songwriter and the songwriter's publishing company, and Little Anthony didn't want to do it. So it went to the Royalettes in 1965, who achieved the number 41 single with this. The most popular version of this came from Denise Williams in 1982. It hit number 10. One that did not chart in 1971 was the title track to the Laura Nyro and LaBelle album, featuring LaBelle the group, not just LaBelle the singer. That's Patti LaBelle, Nona Hendrix, and Sarah Dash. And interesting stuff to look up on the internet. Look up Patti LaBelle and look at her band, the Bluebells. Patti LaBelle and the Bluebells, they came out of a couple of groups that splintered in Philadelphia and Trenton. And the Bluebells became just LaBelle in 1970 and worked with Laura Nyro, which is a pretty good version of it. But, you know, interestingly, though, there's a bridge in the song, the middle eight, and everybody, all three versions of this, use different lyrics in that bridge. I think I'm using the Royalettes version, but who knows? Here we go. Thank you. In 1970, this was the other one that was in the chamber before I got suggestions. Yeah, I should just go with the suggestion, but 1970, this was a kind of a one-hit wonder for this particular band. The guy who formed the band was a guy named Tom Burrows, a British songwriter. And this in 1970 was the first number one hit of the year. The Grassroots passed on this song, but this Tom Burrows guy and his band-ish called Edison Lighthouse did the song, so you'll remember it, I'm sure. One in 1972 was a number 8 single. A fellow who wrote it, Dewey Bunnell, was inspired by a road trip down the California coast. This took when he was a kid. And the Creatures, alligator lizards? Let me check my... Yeah, alligator lizards. Those were actually cloud shapes that he saw as a kid. It was actually on the Pacific Coast Highway. His dad had to stop and change a flat tire. And it was near a road sign for Ventura. So all of this stuff boiled in his head, and he wrote a song about a thoroughfare that doesn't actually exist, Ventura Highway. Mm-hmm.
wishing on a falling star, waiting for the early train. Sorry, Bob, but I've been hit by a purple rain. Oh, come on, Joe, you can always change your name. Thanks a lot, son, just the same.
Another request. That was from 1970, number one song. It was this band's only number one single, which surprises me. Thank you. make some bread. Another request, 1976, this one hit number 28 from her album Thoroughbred. This was written entirely by her, both words and music. I always like this song. Considered it finished. It's still not finished. There's a middle eight that's missing words, and I don't even play it in this rendering of it. But I don't think anyone's heard this, and maybe members of my family as I was practicing it. But it is called Mona Lisa Smile. And I'm still working on it. Enjoy it.
I've been thinking about my baby.
It 40 minutes of hits, like stacks of wax on a Saturday night. Thanks everybody for joining me live from Mount Laurel, New Jersey for episode 95 of the Hack Show, the House Arrest Concert Series. I'll be back next week with episode 96, and it'll give me time to work on all the ones that I rejected as not well played enough for public consumption. So if you want to give me some more suggestions, that's fine. I appreciate them all. They're all very good. So thanks again for joining me, Hack Show fans. And until next time, ciao, ciao.